We have provided the necessary code inside this at one staff public method. And this at one staff public method that we have created is residing inside the class file called cstaffmanager.cs. And this class file is again residing inside this app underscore code special folder. So we have already completed our data layer development stage. And now we need to proceed to the presentation layer development stage. So therefore, I need to go and create a new folder called staff management. And within this folder, I need to add one web form, ADM add staff. What does ADM stand for? Administrator, because usually it's the administrator that will add these staff records, okay? So I would like to go and create a web form that will have the necessary text box drop-down list that will collect staff information from the user. And when the user clicks the button, how should the web form look like? It's supposed to look like this. Okay, so the user will provide information such as Mary. Then the user will provide information such as 11th of December 2000. Then the user might select that this staff will be attached to the sales and marketing department. And when the user click the submit button, it will have the necessary code that will use this at one staff to go and create one staff record inside the staff table. Okay, so how are we supposed to go and proceed? First of all, I will delete all the unnecessary files and begin. Right click on the project title, add a new folder, and the new folder is called staff management. And within this new folder, I would actually like to add a new form, add new item, and this form is actually going to be called ADM add staff. Right, means that this form is going to be used by the administrator. Then of course it will lead me to an editor, and this editor is actually focusing the presentation file of the web form. Now, in order to produce this interface, definitely I must learn how to use server tag to define a text box that will collect the full name. I will need to learn how to use the server tag to define another text box that will collect the date of birth. And I will need to have another set of server tag that will define the drop-down list control. I will also need to learn how to go and use the server tag to define the button. Agree or not? Right? So right now, where am I supposed to go and provide all these server tags? All these server tags must be residing inside the presentation file of the web form. Okay? Now, of course, I'm not going to keep on typing all these necessary HTML code and the server tag. What I'm going to do is that I've already prepared all these necessary code in a separate project, and I'm going to just copy and paste. All these necessary code should be well practiced in the previous two practical sessions or experimental sections when we learn how to go and use server tag to define controls. Okay, so I'm going to place it inside my new blank web form. Right, I'm going to paste it inside my new blank web form. Notice that I'm avoiding the directive line. This is the directive line. This directive line is to tell the visualstudio.net that this ESPX file, presentation file, is going to work together with the code behind file. Now notice that this is the code behind file. If you expand the web form, this is the code behind file. Notice that this is the code behind file, name information, right? So this is the directive line that will set the direction to tell the visualstudio.net that there are two web forms working closely together to provide the add record functionality. So I have already provided the necessary client-side code to define the server tag that will define the drop-down list control. This is the part that will define the drop-down list control, right? You should learn how to go and use this server tag to go and define a drop-down list control that will display three list items or four list items. The first list item is actually having a value of 0, and it will display the text called select department. That's why you see this. That's why you see select department here. Okay, then the next list item is actually going to define an option for the user to select sales and marketing. And when the user selects sales and marketing, we are always interested with the value, because this value is the one needed by our database table here. Okay, right, so let's take a look at the rest of the server tag code which are involved in this web form. Take a look at this. This is the server tag code that will define the text box. The ID of the text box is txt name. The size or the maximum character length that this text box will accept is 100 characters. Let's take a look at another text box having the ID of txt dob. This text box will be in charge of collecting the date information, the date of birth information, right? And it will only allow a maximum character input of 10 characters. Okay, so I have already provided the necessary server tag code inside the web form, and this is actually the code behind file. Now, how am I supposed to go and enter the code behind file? I can double click on it. I will enter the code behind file. Or another way is, since I've already defined the button that the user must take action upon after providing the staff information, when the user click the button, so when I double click this one, you will notice that it will also lead me to the code behind file, which is the adm@staff.aspx.cs. So I need to go and provide the necessary code. The necessary code here. I need to go and provide the necessary code here, right? Which will use the public method. The public method. What is the method? The method is called @onestaff, right? Correct or not? So that one staff record will be created. Besides that, I will also need to display a message to the user. Display a message to the user. Right, to the user. The status of the action. In other words, like one record has been created or zero record has been created, so that the user won't think that the web form has suddenly hung on him. Okay, right, so continue to the next session to find out how to go and provide the CSAP logic to deal with the record creation process.